Did you know that in October 2020, more people died of suicide than from COVID-19 in Japan? Well, that's not the only time when poor mental health become a leading cause of death. According to World Health Organization, suicide is the second leading cause of death, and one person dies of suicide after every 40 seconds. And during this pandemic, all of us are at a risk of developing mental health disorders like depression due to many factors like loss of income, isolation, and fear of getting sick. So at this time, we need mental health awareness more than ever before. Stay tuned to this video and we'll let you know what you can do to boost your mental health, avoid depression, and finally foods that improve overall mental health. Mental health. It's important to note that good mental health depends on a delicate balance of factors and elements that are associated with our daily life and the foods that we eat. Here are the most common factors that cause mental health issues. Continuous social and economic pressure. Having limited financial means or belonging to a marginalized or persecuted ethnic group can increase the risk of mental health disorders. The rat race of better grades, better cars, better houses, and sometimes better appearances puts so much pressure on everyone that it seems quite difficult to get out of the race. The claim of life of social media has even affected people. Jealousy, envy, competition has made us hate our lives and long for other people's lives. Thus, stress, anxiety, and depression adds to the mental pressure. So, let's take a look at some of the early signs of mental health illness. Early signs. There is no way to know if a person has developed a mental illness, but if someone has started acting different, you should look out for these as possible signs of a mental health disorder. Withdrawing from friends, family, and colleagues. Avoiding activities that they would normally enjoy. Sleeping too much or too little. Eating too much or too little. Feeling hopeless. Having consistently low energy. Taking alcohol and nicotine more frequently than before. Displaying negative emotions. Being confused. Being unable to complete daily tasks such as getting to work or cooking a meal, having persistent thoughts or memories that reappear regularly, thinking of causing physical harm to themselves or others, hearing voices and experiencing delusions. Ways to become healthier. One of the best ways is to go to the medical practitioner and address the problem. If that seems difficult, then there are various ways for managing mental health problems. Yet the treatment is highly individual, and what works for one person may not work for another. Looking after mental health can preserve a person's ability to enjoy life. Some strategies or treatment are more successful in combination with others. A person living with a chronic mental disorder may choose different options at various stages in their life. The individual needs to work closely with the doctor who can help them identify their needs and provide them with a suitable treatment. Treatments can include psychotherapy or talking therapies. This type of treatment takes a psychological approach to treating mental illness. Cognitive behavioral therapy, exposure therapy, and dialectical behavioral therapy are the examples. It can help people understand the root of their mental illness and start to work on more helpful thought patterns that support everyday living and reduce the risk of isolation and self-harm. Physical exercise and mental health. You might have exercised a lot for weight loss and fitness, but researchers have found that certain physical activities like brisk walking and cycling can help you with mental health issues like anxiety. Even 10 minutes of brisk walking or cycling can have the potential of lifting your mood, making your mind alert and boosting your energy level. Foot's impact during a brisk walk creates pressure through arteries, which results in better blood supply to the brain. Recently in Sweden, Researchers observed the mental health of 100 teenage girls with mental health issues like depression and anxiety. Girls who regularly joined the weekly dance classes improved their mental health, and effect of these dance classes remained up to 32 weeks even after the dance classes ended. This is because dance involves your full body as well as your brain to access the dance patterns and moves. Self-help. A person with mental health difficulties should make certain changes to their lifestyle to improve their wellness. Such changes might include reducing alcohol intake, sleeping more, and eating a balanced, nutritious diet. People may need to take time away from work or resolve issues with personal relationships that may be causing damage to their mental health. People with conditions such as anxiety or depressive disorder may benefit from relaxation techniques, which include deep breathing, meditation, and mindfulness. We'll be talking about these techniques later in this video. Make self-care a priority. Sometimes we get so busy with our lives and responsibilities that we forget that we are also human beings. Sometimes it seems impossible for you for taking time out for yourself. But if you want a healthy life, start taking care of yourself. It is like the airplane analogy. We must put our oxygen mask on before we can assist others. The simplest things that can promote well-being, such as enough sleep, food, downtime, and exercise, are often the ones overlooked. Ask for support when needed. If you are feeling overwhelmed, reach out to a friend or family member you can talk to. Speaking with a healthcare professional can also reduce stress and help us learn healthier coping strategies. People are prone to react negatively when in anxiety or depression. Avoid activities such as drinking alcohol and self-harming, and immediately shift your mind's concentration to something else. Also, eating too much salty and sugary food during depression can make you more aggressive and put you in a constant guilt for breaking your self-discipline. Cut social activities for a while. Let's say you're invited to a social event this weekend, but you have not had any time for yourself. The idea of reading a book and eating Chinese takeout sounds like your dream, but you're afraid of hurting someone's feeling if you don't attend. But what's the point of going if it will exhaust you by the end of the day? If no one cares, maybe you decide to have a low-key evening by yourself. If someone cares and that relationship matters to you, you'd probably benefit more from making an appearance at the event. Get out of your head. Sometimes it's best not to even try contending with the racing thoughts. Sometimes you just need a break. Distract yourself. Watch a movie, phone, or catch up with a friend. Go for a walk or do something positive that you know takes your mind off things. Affirmations and imagery. The power of positive imagery and affirmations is now scientifically proven to increase positive emotions. Wondering how? When you think of a positive experience, your brain perceives it to be a reality. So you need to replace those negative thoughts with the positive statements and challenge, and change the way you see and experience the world. Meditation and yoga. Yoga is a 5,000 years old physical discipline and a health technique that was originally used as a healing practice for mental and physical illnesses. Unlike regular exercises, yoga is an integrated physical activity that connects your body with your mind. During yoga, deep breathing helps reduce stress and calms down your nerves. Yoga also reduces muscle tension and makes you feel calm and alert about your surroundings and your own body. Deep breathing also improves your sleep and blood flow to your brain. By keeping you in the present moment, yoga and meditation also increase mindfulness and concentration, and it's the key practice that helps in depression. Talk it out. Don't hold it all inside. talk to someone close to you about your worries or the things getting you down. Sharing worries can cut them in half and also give you a chance to laugh at potentially absurd situations. Many of our worries sound a lot less worrisome when we say them loud. If you don't feel up sharing, writing them down is also a great way to release them, or maybe engage with an independent professional. There are plenty of services available, including the free services, which you can quickly Google to find what's available in your city. Foods that boost mental health. Food is deeply linked with the mental health both due to its chemical composition and the physical properties. According to the recent studies, spending time in the kitchen and preparing food for yourself makes you happy and satisfied. It also eases anxiety and depression. On the other hand, consuming salty foods and chocolates during anxiety attacks might make your condition worse than before. However, certain foods have been studied for their powerful properties against depression and anxiety. These include mushrooms, vegetables like pumpkin and broccoli, and fruits like banana and blueberries. Mushrooms are specifically popular for their functions in mental health. They not only combat with the free radicals causing the mental damage, but also improve the cellular oxygenation that reduces chronic fatigue and restlessness. Fruits like banana are rich in tryptophan that is converted by our body into serotonin, a primary brain hormone responsible for lifting our mood and promoting a feeling of well-being. Bananas are also high in potassium, which, if deficient in body, can negatively affect our mood. The body performs well when potassium and sodium are in a good balance, while people nowadays eat too much salt, which disturbs natural sodium-potassium balance. Eating bananas can bring the potassium level to the normal. Green tea is a natural antidepressant, as it contains a significant amount of caffeine that improves mood, alertness, and cognition. Green tea has a variety of components in it that naturally boost the dopamine level in our body. A study done on healthy Korean individuals found that people who consume green tea regularly had 21% lower risk of developing mental health issues like depression. Some studies also suggest that drinking half a cup of green tea every day is as effective as 2 hours of exercise in calming down body and easing anxiety. That's all of today. At the end of this video, I would like to say that mental health needs your willingness to do these exercises, eat these foods, and be positive about your life. So, don't forget to practice some of these things to stay away from mental health issues. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and hit the bell icon for our latest video updates.